Welcome to Food or Not Food, the show where our contestants simply try to identify food. Now in our eighth season, we are still discovering what is food and what is not food. I am your host, Thistley Prickle. Let's see what our contestants have come up with. Nigel, this is a large can of paint and not food. Food. We need it. We love it. What is it? There's gotta be some science here. What fuels our bodies? Why don't we eat things like paint? Let's talk about it. Yeah, that one was low-hanging fruit. What is food?
Food is something you can eat to get healthy and to grow.
Zucchini or apples, or it helps you stay healthy so you could live.
Lettuce, and those are really healthy for you.
And it makes you have energy so you can go out and play.
Our bodies need certain chemicals to do things like walk, sleep, breathe, live. We call these chemicals nutrients, something that provides nourishment to keep our bodies working. We get most nutrients from food. Experiment time! Well, actually this is a dissection, separating something into pieces to examine it. Today we'll dissect a salad. Let us begin. Some nutrients we need lots of and others just a dab will do. Macronutrients, macro means large, are foods we need to eat lots of, like carbohydrates, fats, and proteins. Croutons have carbohydrates, or carbs, that supply energy. Olive oil is a healthy fat that promotes growth and gives long-lasting energy. Add some protein like tofu, beans, or chicken, and your body has what it needs to repair damage, stay healthy, build muscle, and move around. These are all macronutrients. They also contain micronutrients, like vitamins. Micro means small. We need smaller amounts of micronutrients in our diets. Fresh produce, like greens and fruits and vegetables, have macronutrients like fiber, which is a type of carb, as well as micronutrients like vitamins and minerals that keep your digestive system working and support your immune system. Together, macronutrients and micronutrients make a well-balanced diet. Try dissecting one of your own meals. Record your data in a chart, like the one linked below, to see your nutrients add up. Welcome back. Today on Food or Not Food, your challenge is obvious. Simply identify food. No one has done it yet, so in season 8, here we are. It is day 2 of our challenge, and our contestants have yet to discover food. Let's see what you have come up with, Charlotte. Oh, dear sweet Charlotte, you were so close to identifying food. All you had to do was not add the several coins to your ice cream. I am sorry, but this is not food. We've never been able to eat coins, but we used to eat things we don't eat anymore, like raw meat. Our relationship with food has evolved over time. Perhaps over a million years ago, our brains started to grow way faster when we began cooking our food because it was easier to digest and got rid of bacteria that could make us sick. It is our final day and still no food has been spotted. As always, we come now to our prestigious show-stopping round. Martha Francis. My goodness, get the check! Congratulations!
Martha Francis, this is not food.
Extra fun fact, a colorful plate usually means more micronutrients. Not so fast, scientist. Candy colors are food dye, not the natural colors in fruits and veggies. A plate packed with fruits and vegetables makes a colorful, nutritional meal.
And finally, Charlotte, please, step forward. Congratulations, Charlotte! Good on you! Oh, get the check for real! Oh, dear sweet Charlotte, you have identified food in its most basic form! After 8 long, arduous, very grueling seasons, someone has identified food! Well, that's all the food or not food for today. This is your host, Thistley Pickle, reminding you that a balanced meal is quite ideal. And remember to make sure what you eat is actually food.
Food. It seems simple, but I have so many more questions. Why are some red berries awesome to eat and other red berries signal poison? Why can't humans survive by just eating buckets of vitamins? How is it that humans have adapted to identify rotten food and avoid it? Why can we eat raw fish but not raw chicken? Why do diet and exercise go hand in hand? What if you live in a place that doesn't have a grocery store? All these questions are making me hungry. Sounds like good stuff to explore over dinner.
What do you think, scientist?
Watching, scientist. Make sure you're subscribed with your notifications turned on. Share the show with your friends and family and add your thoughts or questions in the comments below. Your comment could spark a future episode of Science with Sophie. Until next time, scientists.